Hi, welcome along to another video. As you know, it's getting harder to reach a safe broadcasting level. All the links to the articles are in the information section of this video. We're going to start with the China dialogue, who rules climate intervention on the high seas. With a range of marine geoengineering field trials moving forward, attention is turning to how research and eventual deployment should be governed. So this article is based on an experiment that's just taken place in Australia. Harrison and his team were there to test a radical intervention that, if successful, could spare the world's largest coral reef from total loss. Known as marine cloud brightening, their approach involves spraying seawater into the air to help form bright clouds that reflect sunlight and cool the waters below. This is like putting the reef on life support. It buys us some time. Obviously, bringing emissions down is the critical thing. So in the Australian ABC News, saviour or scientific hubris, geoengineering the planet to counter climate change. It's from ABC Radio National. Hugh Hunt, the acting director of the newly created Centre for Climate Repair at Cambridge University, credits the Oxford principals with putting a brake on the first wave of geoengineering trials, including his project SPICE, Stratospheric Particle Injection for Climate Engineering. Just like to remind Hugh that really, kind of needs to get his story straight there, because at the time it was released that the SPICE project didn't go ahead because of the private financial issues. I mean, we all know it didn't go ahead because of the amount of noise the public made about it to people in Norfolk, UK, when the nature reserves found out about what was just about to take place above their reserves, and the local radio found out. The public soon kicked up, and that's why you do activism, because you have the power to stop it. We know that because we've already stopped experiments. The Shepherd of the Hills Gazette, ABC. Why are there no giant scale geoengineering experiments? Well, there are, if you start looking in the 1990s, but if you're looking in the 2020s, yeah, you might miss that one. So ABC, why are there no giant scale geoengineering experiments? Same article, geoengineering the planet to counter climate change, ABC Radio National. The Associated Press, for some reason, wants us to all think back 12 years to the Beijing Olympics. Yahoo Sports, China even attempted to control the weather at the Olympics with cloud seeding. It seemed to work a few days into the games as smog and soot cleared and the sun shone. It also helped that heavy industry was closed for months and the vehicles pulled off the streets. In the Sentinel Record, also the Associated Press article, one question hung over 2008 games, would they change China? China even attempted to control the weather at the Olympics with cloud seeding, another show of its ambition. It seemed to work. A few days after the games opened, the smog, etc., etc. So we note the extra addition of another show of its ambition to that paragraph. Over to the Star Tribune. One question hung over 2008 games. Would they change China? Associated Press. And yeah, the same bit in the Star Tribune. On Netflix, San Angelo Regional Airport featured on Netflix special. San Angelo is featured in the show because of the West Texas Weather Modification Association. This program, run out of Mathis Field, helps increase the chances of rain in West Texas. Since 2004, the West Texas Weather Modification Association has helped increase precipitation by 16%, which translates to an additional 2.25 inches across the area, states the West Texas Weather Modification Association website. We've covered these before, and the South Texas Weather Modification Association, and I believe North Texas Weather Modification Association. But your weather's not modified. Hey, if you don't fancy Netflix, there's on UGE Tube, there's a video, The Weather is Changing, full HAARP chemtrail documentary 2014, high definition. Haven't watched it, might be worth a watch, might just be something you've already seen, who knows. In the Chemical and Engineering News, Atmospheric Chemistry, How Marine Bacteria Influence Cloud Formation. It's always good to see the word illuminate in a title. We love a bit of illumination. This article basically identifies, or tries to identify, how aerosols are created naturally within the environment. However, the aerosol connection was difficult to make. After years of trying, they found that no matter how high they made the bacterial concentrations, they could not drive the formation of aerosols, until they added some reactive gases to replicate human influence on the atmosphere. Speaking in a presentation in the Division of Physical Chemistry, the team reported that they found that hydroxyl radicals oxidized gaseous DMS, dimethyl sulfate, leading to the formation of sulfate aerosols. Sulfate aerosols in turn can seed cloud formation. What has that got to do with weather modification? It's all natural, right? And that's the whole idea. It's to normalize it. So basically, when you can explain it in the natural world, this normalizes it for people, where they can then say, well, if it happens in nature without a problem, it won't be a problem to mimic nature chemically or engineeringly, will it? So you understand what that's about, don't you? You can see that. You read through the lies. Let's move on. The New Straits Times, Malaysia, August the 5th. Since rainfall had not been reported in the Teluk Pahang catchment area, which led to the water level drop to 19%, state government decided to continue with 8 cloud seeding exercises. He said an allocation had been approved to carry out cloud seeding, but cautioned it would not guarantee rain would fall or fall in the right location. Sensible. In another article, Teluk Pahang Dam can only last 52 days. 8 cloud seeding operations, etc., etc. The primary objective of cloud seeding operations is to replenish raw water reserves immediately. The second objective is to achieve healthy and safe status of the dam's effective capacity by December 2020, in preparation for the annual dry season anticipated in January 2021. Still in the locality of Malaysia, Southeast Asia, so Malaysia, Indonesia, Singapore. Southeast Asia likely spared smoke haze as rain damps fires. This is in Bloomberg. This is about Indonesia. Meanwhile, the government has conducted cloud seeding since March to dampen peatland. Also, in another version of Bloomberg, Southeast Asia likely spared choking haze as rain damps fires. Indonesia plans to continue cloud seeding, etc., etc. South China Morning Post, a Bloomberg article. Indonesia's rain during dry season means Southeast Asia may be spared toxic haze this year. And it's the same information. Forest News, a perfect storm, fire, haze and a global health crisis. The Indonesian Ministry of Environment and Forestry explained that the Indonesian government has put early warning and detection systems in place for peatland areas, and has been applying early weather modification techniques, artificial rains, to reduce the likelihood of these crucial carbon-rich ecosystems catching light. Over to India, Hindustan Times. Is cloud seeding well worth the effort? Scientists to launch knowledge. The Union Ministry of Earth Sciences would quickly launch a white paper on whether or not cloud seeding is a viable know-how to set off rainfall. So there's the article in the Hindustan Times. Also in India, intersectional feminism, feminism in India, geoengineering and its gendered effects, a case for feminist scientific leadership. So we pick up a couple of statements in this. Recently, scientists working on a marine geoengineering project in the Great Barrier Reef began test trials. An engineered nozzle system sprayed microscopic water droplets into the air above the reef to deflect sunlight from hitting the ocean surface. That ties in with where we started this week's video. Environmental groups expressed concern in response to the trials. Over the years, eco-feminists have raised concern over geoengineering's hyper-masculinist approach towards addressing the climate crisis. Fair play, but there are just as many women out there promoting the new speak neuro-linguistic program in so-called journalism articles out there as well. It's not specifically unique to men, is it? Let's be honest. The idea of fixing damaged biophysical systems through a one-size-fits-all engineered approach is dangerous, as it may have unintended consequences, which we would all agree with, man, woman, and everyone else, whoever you identify as. We're all pretty clear on this on planet Earth now, I think. It's not about race, it's not about colour, it's not about religion, it's not about your gender identity. There is only one thing that a human being is about, and that's whether you're a good person or a bad person. Whether you're currently a good person or you're currently a bad person. Each person could change from good to bad, bad to good. But essentially, that's the only difference. Don't worry about anything apart from whether someone's a good person or a bad person. Try and be a good person. That's all we can do. If we all strive for that, we stand a chance, don't we? Many of you would be prepared for these times that we're going through. No one said it was going to be easy. You're getting everything you ever wanted, and at the same time, it's everything you ever feared, that we all feared. It's going to be messy, going to be quite noisy. You've been told for many years, don't lose your head. And this is how you know you're not going to lose your head, is because you're not a zombie, are you? Hey. So if you can answer this question to yourself, am I a zombie? The answer is no. Well then, you're not going to lose your head. You're going to make it through to the other side of this time that humanity is going through. People are just working out for the first time ever where the true prison walls are. Society has tried over thousands of years to break through those walls, and all they found was another wall, and then they broke through that wall, and then they found another wall. Now we are in a time where we see the true walls. It's all sounding a bit Pink Floyd, isn't it? Hey, see you later. Take care of yourselves, take care of everybody else around you. If you can help, help. If you can't, don't feel guilty. You're probably supposed to be doing something else. Best wishes. See you next time.